Hello everyone, welcome back. Now moving on towards the next image characteristic, that is the radiographic contrast. So we have already seen about the radiographic density, which is one of the image characteristic from oral radiology. Now what do you mean by radiographic contrast? So it is defined as it is the difference in the densities between the light and the dark regions on a radiograph. Now we have seen what exactly density was. So density is nothing but the degree of blackness. That means if you have a film which is having a high density, so that means you will see that film as dark in color, that is it will have more blackish color. And if it is having low density, so that means that film, it will appear more whitish. So now this contrast is nothing but the difference in the densities between the light and the dark region on a radiograph. Or it is also defined as it is the difference between the brightness of the image and that of the surrounding field. So it is nothing but the difference between the brightness, that is if that image is too bright or if it is not. So it is nothing but the difference between the brightness of the image and the surrounding field. So the darkest area is black and the lightest is white. So in this you will see over here, so this is an example for the difference in the contrast. So over here this is the one which is having low contrast, and over here this film is having high contrast. So high contrast is when it will appear more black and white, and light contrast is when you will see the image which is having more of grayish color. So the minimum contrast which can be detected visually under the best condition, it is about 0.02. So contrast is nothing but the difference between the density. So the formula for it is C is equal to D2 minus D1. Now we have three scenarios again in the film, that it can have high contrast, low contrast, or the optimum contrast that we exactly want. So high contrast, it will be when the film, they have many black and white areas and very few shades of gray. Now over here, this is the X-ray of chest. Now you can see this film is having high contrast. So because of that, it is having black and white color and very less of gray. So that becomes a high contrast film. But now this high contrast film, it is useful in detection of the dental caries, like how is the progression and the detection of the dental caries. So now this high contrast film, it will be helpful for your dental caries, and sometimes it is called as a short gray scale of contrast, because now in this you have very less of the gray color, and because of that it is known as a short gray scale. So in this, the lower kilovoltage peak, that is having the range of 65 kilovoltage peak, that results in a short gray scale of contrast. So if you'll see that the kilo voltage peak is in the range, so it is lower, so it is in the range of 65 kilo like voltage peak, so it will have this high contrast. Now what do you mean by low contrast? So low contrast film, it will have many shades of gray instead of black and white. Now over here, now you can see this is a low contrast film, so it is like appearing more that is having gray color instead of black and white when you're comparing it with a high contrast film. So now this is also called as a long gray scale of contrast, because now in this you have many shades of gray, but the shades of gray, they are different. But over here in low contrast, you will have more of gray color shade. So now it is useful for the detection of the periodontal and the periapical diseases. So now we have seen in the high contrast, it is useful in dental caries, whereas low contrast, it is useful in the detection of the periodontal and the periapical diseases, and it is because of the high kilovoltage peak, which is in the range of 70 to 75 kilovoltage peak. So in this you will see it is inversely proportional. That means if the kilovoltage peak, it is going on increasing, so the contrast, it goes on decreasing. So over here now you can see high contrast is because of the lower KVP and low contrast is because of high KVP. Now what do you mean by step wedge? So it is nothing but a device which is used to demonstrate the short and the long scale contrast. Now what are the factors which are affecting the contrast of the film? So there are these four factors, that is the first one is the factors in relation with the patient. The next one is the factors in relation with the X-ray machine. The next one is the factors in relation with the film. And the next one is the factors in relation with the processing of the film. So now we are going to see each one. Starting with the first one, that is the factors in relation with the patient. Now we know the patient, they are known as subject. So because of that, it is called as a subject contrast. And this is due to the difference which is caused by the different degree of attenuation of the X-ray beam when it is transmitted through different parts of the patient's tissue. Now what do you mean by attenuation? So attenuation is nothing but the reduction in some value. So over here, it will be the reduction in the intensity of your X-ray beam. So if the intensity of the X-ray beam, it is different, and when it is transmitted through different parts of the patient tissue, so it will show different contrast. So over here, it is dependent on three factors, that is the tissue thickness. Now over here, the difference in the tissue thickness, it affects the contrast of the film. That means the contrast, it will be less if the tissue thickness is less. So it is directly proportional. So if the tissue thickness, so if there's a tissue which is thin, so in that case, you'll see the contrast of the film will be less. And if the tissue thickness is more, so in that case, there will be high contrast on your film. So this was your first factor. The next factor is the tissue density. Now over here, the difference in the density of the tissue of the patient, it affects the resultant contrast. So the tissue density, it also affects the contrast of the film. The third factor is the atomic number. Now over here, the absorption, it increases in the substances which is having high atomic number. So in this, you will see that the bone, it attenuates more X-rays when you're comparing it with the muscles or the fat which is having equal thickness. So that means the contrast, it will be more if the atomic number is more. So that means it is directly proportional. So if the atomic number of particular substance is more, so it will have higher contrast. The next are the factors in relation with the X-ray machine. Now we know we have that control panel in which we have different parameters. So if you do changes in those parameters, then that can affect the contrast of the film. So the first one is the kilovoltage peak. So we have earlier seen that if the kilovoltage peak is high, then the contrast of the film will be low. So this is nothing but it is inversely proportional. So if the higher kilovoltage peak is used, then more X-ray it penetrates the film. And because of that, you will have more shades of gray, which is nothing but your low contrast film. So in this, if you are using a high kilovoltage peak, then the contrast, it will be low. And if the kilovoltage peak is low, then the contrast will be high. That means it is inversely proportional. Now the next factor is the penetration power. So the penetrating power of the radiation beam, it affects the contrast. And the third factor is your exposure rate. So the brightness of the film, it is directly proportional to the exposure rate of the incident X-ray. So the brightness, it is directly proportional to the brightness of the film. It will increase if the exposure rate is increased. But now over here, if any changes in exposure time in excess, it causes the low contrast. But if you are making any changes in the exposure time excessively, so that will result in the low contrast. So these are the factors in relation with the X-ray machine. Now the next are the factors in relation with the film. So first one is the optical density. So the film with high or low densities, they show poor contrast. So the film, it should have that proper optimal diagnostically proper or useful like density, so that you should have that proper like contrast. So if the density is low or high, so it will show poor contrast. Now over here, this is nothing but a characteristic curve which we have already seen in the video of radiographic density. Now over here, this is nothing but it will show a relationship between the density, contrast, then the exposure rate, then the speed of the film and the latitude. Now over here, these are the two speeds of the film. And in this, you'll see as you're increasing the exposure rate, the density, it goes on increasing. So in this, you'll see that the density and the contrast, they should be in that proper range to be like useful for your film. The next one is the speed of the film. Now in this, if you're using a high speed film, so that means the contrast, it will be low. So it is nothing but inversely proportional. The next one is the type of the film, whether you're using a direct film or indirect film. So the if you're using a direct film, so it will show like adequate contrast. And if you're using an indirect film, that is nothing but with the intensifying screen, so it will show less contrast. Now, what are these various types of like film, that is depending on the speed, then this type and emulsion. So I've already covered in the types of the film. So if you want to see like what exactly all this are, so you can see that video of the types of film. And the next factor is the emulsion. So if you're using a double emulsion film, so it will show less contrast. And if you're using a single emulsion film, so it will show like high contrast. And in this also, if you're using a film which is having thicker emulsion, so that produces good contrast than the one which is having a thinner emulsion. So these are the various factors in relation with the film. The next are the factors in relation with the processing of the film. So if the film, it is overdeveloped or if it is underdeveloped, so that film, it will show low contrast. And if the developing solution is having higher temperature, so the contrast, it will be high. So basically, it's like if you are doing the overdevelopment or if the film, it is underdeveloped, so it will show low contrast only, and it will show high contrast if the temperature of your developing solution is high. So that is about the processing of the film. The next factor is about the scattered radiation. Now, as the name says, the radiation they are getting scattered, and because of that, the contrast it will be reduced. The next factor is about the fog. Now, we know what exactly is that fogging. So fogging is nothing but the blurring effect. So fog, it may appear due to the improper film storage, contaminated developer solution, or the excessive time of development. So fog on your film, it can appear because of any this reason. That can be if you are not storing your film properly, or if the developer solution is contaminated, or if you are excessively like developing the film. So all that can lead to fogging, and that fogging, it like results in the reduction of your contrast. So these are the factors in relation with the processing of the film. That was all about the radiographic contrast, which is one of the image characteristics. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, then please like, comment, share, and do subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much.